لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I request all the sisters, please be quiet and listen the khutbah. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those who are listening, please do not interrupt them. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. Dear brothers and sisters, I advise all of you, including myself, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be feared. Dear brothers and sisters, this is the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us the month of Ramadan, and at the end of the Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this opportunity to celebrate the Eid. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا ولك الشكر شكرا على ذلك. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his favors. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a complete and full thank. Dear brothers and sisters, as you know that many Muslims have many concerns about their religion these days. Issues are coming and raised by the other people one by another. People are thinking and protesting about one problem and the second is already over there. As you know, few months before, we were raising the voices against those people who have insulted the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the people have done their part by shouting or by protesting, and the new fitna, the new trial for the Muslim Ummah is ready, that the people, the ashrar, the evil people who have no belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who do not know even their own scriptures, they are ready to burn the other people's scripture. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded all the Muslims that do not insult other people's religion, do not insult other people's whoever they worship, as they would insult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without realizing. So we are not allowed to insult anybody. But dear brothers and sisters, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the best example for all of us. So whenever these troubles and problem comes, how we should tackle it, how we should face it, alhamdulillah, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. The month of Quran, which we have just passed, the month of Ramadan, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the Quran, and this is the barakah of the Quran, that the month which has revealed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the month of full of blessings that each single deed which we perform, it will be multiplied by 10 to 700 times. And the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the month who have full honor because Quran was revealed in this month. Not only the Quran, but other scriptures also revealed in the month of Ramadan. And the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wherever He revealed it, that Quran, the city which was revealed, that city became secret city, honorable city, Makkah al-Mukarramah and Madinah al-Munawwarah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the Quran. We have just finished the month of Quran. The duties which come over us, that we have to look after the Quran. Not only in Ramadan, but all after the Ramadan. Because the Lord, which we have worshipped in Ramadan, He is the same Lord after the Ramadan. The Quran, the purpose of the revelation of the Quran, it was the same purpose in Ramadan and in after the Ramadan. So dear brothers and sisters, we must hold the rope of the Quran. Because the Quran, one side is in the hand of the human being, so another side is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever holds the Quran, he will never be strayed. And this is the book Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored upon the people. That the people will be blessed by this book as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has counted this book as rahmah, mercy for entire nations. Dear brothers and sisters, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he has said that إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ. This is the book, Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the ranks of the people through this book, and Allah described another nation because of this book. Subhanallah, if we do not bother about this book, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would destroy. You can see the punishments Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran. The previous people who have been destroyed, and their name is just there, and their signs has been perished. So these people, this happened to them because they did not bother about their revelation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all of us from his trials and troubles. At the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people have a lot of concerns about the Quran. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they said, "O Prophet, bring another book, not the Quran. Bring another book, because we cannot take the Quran. Or change the Quran from yourself and tell the people something else, but not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed." But what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did? Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam listen to those people? Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam protest against these people? No, subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has done as Quran has mentioned in Surah Al-Hijr, that waqul inni ana an-nadhir al-mubin. Tell to these people, I am a clear warner. I am not going to stop my mission because of your sin. I am not going to stop reciting Quran and acting accordingly because somebody is saying something to the Quran. Because he is a jahil. Because he is an ignorant person about the Quran. He doesn't know anything about the Quran. That's why he has said something about the Quran. But when the people listen to the Quran, subhanallah, they had no choice except surrendering to the Quran. Surrendering themselves to the Quran, submitting themselves to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clearly mentioned that he is the clear warner. Whatever people do, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not stop from his mission. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that كَمَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَى الْمُقْتَسِمِينَ الَّذِينَ جَعَلُوا الْقُرْآنَ عِيضِينَ. Those people who have made the Quran in parts. Subhanallah, at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people made fun of the Quran. Some of them said that the Quran is the magic word. Some of them said this is the just path which will take you astray, away from the forefathers thing. And people have surrendered the Quran by many things. But what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never bothered. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam carried out his mission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَسْأَلَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. By your Lord, whoever is saying something to the Quran, whoever is insulting the Quran, we will definitely gather them on the day of judgment. We will definitely gather them for account. This is the warning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never go back from the promises He makes. So listen, whoever is insulting the Quran, whoever is not bothering about the Quran, Allah will gather them and Allah says, أَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ And Allah will account them about those things which they were doing. But as a Muslim, what we should do? We just show off anger for a week or so and just we keep quiet? No, dear brothers and sisters. This should not be our matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ Do with full effort whatever you have been commanded. The command Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is the same command given to all the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Each one of us, every single of us is the same responsible as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the responsible to his companions that we are here for the people. We are here to bring them from the hellfire to the Jannah, from the darkness to the light, from the wrong path to the straight path. فَاسْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ Clearly explain to them what it has been revealed.